Once upon a time, there lived a little girl named Red Riding Hood. Presenting the Little Red Riding Hood. Once upon a time, there lived a girl who loved her red cape so much that she wore it every day. Because of this, everybody in her town called her Little Red Riding Hood. One day, her mother called out to her, "Red Riding Hood, take this basket of food to your granny's house as she has not been well. But remember, don't stray away from the path in the forest, as it would be very dangerous." "Okay, mother," said Red Riding Hood, and set out with the basket to go to her granny's house. Red Riding Hood was hopping on her way, and little did she know that there was a big bad wolf lurking behind the trees, waiting to eat her and the food in her basket. The wolf came and questioned her as to where she was going. When he came to know that she was on her way to her granny's house, he thought of tricking her. He suggested that she pick out some flowers from the forest to cheer her granny up. While Red Riding Hood was doing so, the wolf quickly rushed to the granny's house. He pretended to be Red Riding Hood and entered her house. He then locked Granny in the cupboard. Before doing so, he stole her cap and he wore it on his head. He then took her place on the bed. Red Riding Hood picked the flowers and continued on to her granny's house. When she reached the house, she called out to her granny and placed the flowers in the vase. When she went closer to her granny, something didn't look right. She asked her granny, "My, what big eyes you have." "It's all the better to see you with, my dear," responded the wolf. "Granny, what a deep voice you have," said Red Riding Hood. "It is all the better to greet you with, my dear," responded the wolf. Red Riding Hood then saw his big hands and asked, "What big hands you have, Granny?" "It's all the better to hug you with, my dear," said the wolf. Finally, she saw the wolf's big teeth and said, "My goodness, Granny, what big teeth you have." "It's all the better to eat you with, my dear," responded the wolf. He then jumped out of bed and grabbed Red Riding Hood. "Help, help," shouted Red Riding Hood. A hunter walking nearby heard her screams and rushed into the house to help her. The hunter killed the wolf and rescued her granny. Red Riding Hood gave her granny the food, hugged her, and they lived happily ever after. The end. This was the first time that I tried to narrate a story using one of my quiet books. So let me know in the comment section below if you enjoyed this narration. You can also let me know what other stories you would like me to base my future quiet books on. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Bye!